Amplify your passion for the guitar for a few dollars per month. Head over to theguitarchannel.biz. Welcome to the Guitar Channel. I am super happy to welcome you. A new incredible interview. I am in the middle of the X Jam and I have right next to me the one and only Mike Kinnelly, who is actually playing tonight at the X Jam. Mike, how are you doing today?
Good. I'm very good, yeah.
Is it possible to pick up for you your best memories of playing with Frank?
Gosh.
Yeah.
I think the very first show is maybe the most enduring memory, which was in Albany, New York.
Okay.
And I was born in New York, so there was a certain feeling of homecoming.
Mm-hmm.
And it was also not just my first gig with him, but my first professional gig of any kind. I was just literally just jumped in the
not
deep.
Not a bad way to start a professional career?
No, not. But also, you know, kind of a little bit daunting, you know. But it's everything about it just felt very comfortable and fun and cool, and what I was expecting to be a really nerve-wracking experience turned it into almost like a fantasy experience, how well it went.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
So that really sticks in the memory.
What do you think is the Frank Zappa legacy?
Oh man, well, the more I listen to the music as time goes on, I feel more and more of him in it, overwhelmingly, I just hear somebody who did only what they wanted to do, musically, artistically. They were entirely uncompromised in that way, and uncompromising. And I think that mindset has become fairly par for the course with a lot of younger artists who aren't beholden to a major label structure. There's nothing stopping them from doing exactly what they want, and I think that the reality of that even being something an artist could do, you know, a choice they could make, that early on Frank was like one of the first artists who made any kind of impact on the mainstream who demonstrated that you could do precisely that. You could do only what you want to do, and you can present it as caustically and uncommercially as you like, and if you have the strength of your convictions behind it, it's going to make an impact. You know, it's like that. Frank couldn't get too weird musically, and he still managed never to shake his following. You know, and he got weird. He got really weird, but there was no too weird he could get to lose the people who were really into what he was doing, and that. You know, that contingency just kept growing and growing and growing. You know, for every weird left turn he took musically, he might, you know, lose one disappointed metal fan or something, but he'll gain like a bunch of other people who are just interested in artists who have weird uncompromising vision and pull the stuff off, you know.
What is your favorite Frank Zappa tune to play live?
We're doing one tonight. It's an instrumental called Alien Orifice that is I just think is an incredibly beautiful piece, and it's really challenging to play. So if I manage to actually get through it, I feel like that's, you know, a personal achievement. It's such a strange, beautiful melody, and unlike a lot of his melodies, most of it just pivots on one note, but it keeps dancing around this one note.
Okay.
Like the melody is rum pa da da pa 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 da 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 rum pa da 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 da, and then it goes back to that note, but the chord changes underneath it, so the same note suddenly has a completely different meaning, and then the decorations change their little dance that it does outside of that one note as the theme develops. It's just really cool. It's just as a writing thing, I think it's just super fun, and it's incredibly fun to play. So I always look forward to that one.
Okay.
Amplify your passion for the guitar for a few dollars per month. Head over to theguitarchannel.biz.